Hello there, my good friends of YouTube. a few things for you today on this video. So I've not been doing very many videos lately. I've had quite a lot of stuff to do and sort out, and I had quite a good some good positive feedback from the car scrapyard. You all enjoyed that one. I had a lot of you emailing me and saying how great it was. Yes, it is. It was a very, very big scrapyard. I don't often get that oftenly go down to that car scrapyard because there's nothing more of interest for me. I normally go there just to find any, you know, these sort of things, these ignition coil transformers, which come in handy because they give out quite a good punch, some of these. And I found this one, of course, and I found in a car a flyback transformer, which there was a monitor, in the 14-inch monitor in the back of a car. So I took this out of it. Nice big capacitor in there, as you can see. I didn't have time to unsolder it there, so I just unsoldered it, and didn't have my soldering iron on me, so I just ripped it out. But yeah, got quite a nice capacitor on that one. And a friend Ben, a subscriber of mine, has sent me some money down as he wanted one of these. This a rather large flyback, so I'm sending you one of these, mate. I've already boxed it up. This is it's exactly the same as this one, but yours has got a red high voltage lead out of it, and it is a very, very big flyback. It's actually one of the biggest ones I've actually got out of monitors and TVs. Be careful though, because it's got an internal capacitor, mate, and it will give you a nasty nip if you don't short it out afterwards, so do watch your fingers with that, mate. And what I'm doing today, guys, I'm actually trying a load of different MOSFETs. I've got quite a lot of different types of MOSFETs here, all rated at different voltages and current. Some fast switching, some very, very fast switching. Even all the way down to the old IRFP260N, which is down there, which is a 200 volt 50 amp, and that's the 260N, which is the ordinary just IRFP260 is a 39 amp at 200 volts, I believe it is, or 250 volts. I'll have to double check that one. But the 260N is 50 amps at 200 volts. So I'll read out some of these which I'm trying for you, which I'm trying on this little old circuit here. Oscillating circuits, they've got a potentiometer so you can change the frequency on that one. Right, I'll read out some of these what I'm trying for you. This is a 47N6C3, then there's a FS7SM, and then there's a G4PH50, 2SC2625, then we've got the IRGPH50, then we've got the IRFPG40, then we've got the W12NK90, and then we've got the W9NK90. Very, very similar ones there. Then we've got the K-series. I like the K-series MOSFETs, they're pretty cool. This is the K2847, then there's the K1120, and then the IRFP260N. So I've not got the schematics of all of these, of you know, the data of what voltage and amps these are. If you've got any of them yourself and you're seeing, you're quite happy with the outputs of what these give off, then just Google it and it'll bring up something for you. So I'll try these out for you one by one, being quick as I can. Try not to take too much of your time up, guys. Here we go. Right, this is the first one. Let's just bring these contacts together. I've rewound the primary on this one. I've got 12 turns on it instead of 8. There was originally 8 odd turns on this, and the 12 turns seems to run better. So secondary is perfectly fine, though. You get a good output from the secondary. There we go. Pretty good output from that. I do believe I was drawing some amps there on that one. Is it hot? A little bit warmer than normal. That's the 47N. Pretty good output from that one. Because if it jumps across the gap just there, I know it's very, very fast switching and it'll actually jump over. Because I normally have it around about there. If it jumps over there, we know it's good and fast. So, let's try it on the next one. Right, gate and drain. Source. Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you, I'm putting 15 volts into this circuit, guys, if I've not already told you. Let's put a bit of plastic under there just to stop it from arcing out to the heat sink. That's the last thing we want. Right, let's try the next one. Oh, nothing yet. Won't even arc across. Let's change the frequency. Nope, nothing at all. So we know the FS7 is not a fast enough switching. Right, and gate, and drain, and source. So, gate, drain, source, for any of you that don't know. Right, let's try the next one. Oh yes, definitely. Noisy bloody thing, wasn't it? So that G4PH50 is working very well indeed. See if it's hot? Not even room temperature. Above room temperature at all. So that must be a very good one. Right. Let's try the 2SC, gate, drain, source. And Larry, if you have not got me messages, mate, your package is on its way. I sent it yesterday. If you didn't get my message. Right, let's try this one. Oh, I believe we got a dead. I believe we got a dead one here. That one doesn't like that one at all. I think I've killed that one on the last run, you know, because I did a video not long ago and the bloody memory was full on my phone, so I had to delete some old videos. But sorry, guys, the 2SC is unfortunately fried. Let's move this heatsink out of the way. God, bloody phone. Right, let's try the next one. Start the IRG. Bloody hell, a bit of solder on the bottom of that leg and it won't allow me to get the clip on. There we go, we're on. Right, let's see how this one gets on. See if it's warm. Just a little bit more than room temperature. It's understandable really, for saying it's been put under load. But I should have actually put the amp meter on actually and see how much amps it's drawing. I bet it's around about 5-6 amps it was drawing at that. Oh, you bugger, that was hot. Put me a bloody wrist on it. These contacts just there on the output. Electrodes. Bloody hot and it just touched my wrist. Right, let's try the IRFP G40. nothing there yet. Nope. And it's getting hot. So that is absolutely pants. Let's try the next one, which is the W12NK. I've got that many MOSFETs, and transistors and stuff. I could bloody do this all day. Right, let's try you. Nope. Didn't like that at all. Change of frequency. Nope. So that one's crap. Let's try the next one. No. It's not even fast switch, not fast enough switching, that one isn't. Just a moderate. And that was the W9NK90. Alright, let's try the key series. My friend Pete Ritchie, he likes his key series transistors, MOSFETs. They are good though, you get some really fast switching ones. Alright, let's try this one. Not quite fast enough for that series one. Nope. Let's try the next K series. Is it hot? Just a little bit more than room temperature. It's fast switching, but not ultra fast. I was sat here the other day and I was just messing around with something and a bloody spider dropped straight down the back of my bloody neck. I went mental. I don't mind spiders at all, but when they're not, I don't know where they are and what they're doing. No thank you, sir. And I just felt it just land on the back of my neck. It had come down off the top of the roof on a bloody spider web and just dropped straight down the back of my neck. I was dancing all over the place trying to get this thing out. It dropped out the bottom of my t-shirt. Bloody thing. It was one of those black jumping ones, the English black jumping ones. I'll have to show you sometime. Right, let's try this K1120, see how this one is. Nope. What a shame. And not. And on the next one. The next one is the classic IRFP260N. Which should be awesome. No messing about with these. You can tell that straight away. See, these are fast switching, but they're not ultra fast. Right, which one was it that was on here, which was a really good one? I believe that was the G4PH, which was the really good one, wasn't it? Which just literally had it arcing over without even trying to arc it itself. I put that in right order. No, it's just a little bit more than room temperature. So I know that one is a good one. I've been meaning to do this video for a while, just to show you different MOSFETs and how fast they switch. You know, which rule the ones out, which are pretty decent and which are crap. But there's absolutely thousands of different types of MOSFETs out there, different brands and stuff, and you'd be here all day trying to configure out which is the best ones. So normally it's word of mouth of what's a good MOSFET or not. But I can definitely say that the G4PH50UD is an amazing MOSFET. Now I have to look out now and see if I've got loads of these. But yeah, thing I wanted to point out as well, guys, and tell you, is I found this. They're knocking down the flats next door to me. They've been knocking them down for some time now, and they finally started doing it. Alex knows about it, and my friend Pete Ritchie knows about it, and John High Voltage Projects knows about it as well. And they give me two phones, you know, these video phones from the doors. You know, you see who's coming to your door and you can press a button and talk to them through the handset. And they gave me two. I asked for them, of course, and I've got two. Pretty cool, eh? And what I was going to say to you is I've rigged up a camera to it, which is that one up there. Can you see it? It's on the top just there. That. I've got it there. Quite easy to wire up. It's just a few wires in the back. It's quite straightforward. And what I was going to say to you guys is I want to give one away. I want to give that away, and I want to give a camera away. All in one thing. I don't want no money for it, and it's going to be in the next video. The next time I do a video, the first person to watch that video, I shall send it to you. I don't care where it is, where in the world it is, I'll send it to you free of charge, because I've got one spare, and I just want to give something back to you subscribers. So I thought I'd leave it till the last minute, because the people who do watch the videos and don't watch things all the way till the end will miss out on the chance. So the first person to message in my next video, no matter what it is, and give me, you know, just basically mention the CCTV little camera. It's classed as a CCTV camera. They work on 12 volts. Unfortunately, these are black and white, and these are a colour camera, but they're still good, and it's still good for nothing. So, next video, first person to comment on that video and watch that video, I'll send it to you, no problem. So, thanks for watching, guys. Look after yourselves. And be safe, and we'll speak again.